All right. Welcome, everyone. This will be the fifth match in the ESL CPS 15 Group 3 between Team Q and Sir, or Like a Sir. We will be starting off with the 5 versus 5, I think. As you might know, this format has 3 maps. First map is usually the 1v1 and the 2v2. Second map is a 3v3. And the third map is 5v5, but we're starting off with the 5 versus 5 here. Lineup for Team Q is Adri, Razor, Kalket, Warlord, and Awe. And for Sir, we have Maktikt, Teftonak, Rizu, Sio, and Kawi. Oh, Maktikt making a mistake here, or well, having a bug, I guess. Whatever you prefer. We have Razor, Awe, and Kalket for Team Q in the lead. Awe having a little bit of a slowdown there, and Kawi now in third place. So right now, this is gonna be a Q round, I think. But of course, these are maps from around 1 minute long, so you never know what's gonna happen. Some very tricky parts in it as well. So in front, we still have Razor and Kalket for Team Q. Oh, and Razor made a mistake there, but this will still be a red round for Team Q. Kalket in first place, followed by Rizu and Kawi. Into the second round we go. Point limit is, as I think, is 7 points for this map, or for this matchup. I think the 2v2 is 5 point limit. Because there are a lot of draws possible. Let's follow Awe here in the second round. See what he can do. We have two players of Sir in the lead. Well, it's kind of one big pack still. Maktikt in the lead for Rizu. Adri in second place now. Awe also taking Rizu. So let's see, Adri with a little bit more speed than Maktikt here. Oh, and Awe with a little bump there, that's unfortunate. It's a pretty tricky part there, the little jump. So we have Maktikt in the lead before Adri, Kalket, and Awe. Wow, and Adri, I don't know what he was doing there, but he just jumped. I don't know. I don't know what happened there, what the hell. He just took the ramp and flew off to the moon, I guess. Alright, let's follow Sion here. There we go. Like a Sir, I believe, consists of mostly former players of IGN Core, I believe. I don't know a lot about them, to be honest. Sion in the lead here. Adri right behind him. Went Awe coming with a lot of speed there. Going pretty wide though. Gonna lose some... no. Wow, Adri with a lot of speed there, taking first place. And Razor now also in front. Razor with a bum there and on that jump, I think. But Adri with a pretty big lead here. He got like 0.4 seconds lead. Which is pretty huge. Very nice round by Adri there. And another red round, so it's gonna be 3-0 for Team Q here in 5v5. Let's follow Razor here for the fourth round. Oh, and someone made a mistake there in the start, I think. Might have been. Right, well, it might have been Sion, or it might have been a lag. That happens. We have three Q players in the lead here, with Awe, Kalket, and Razor. Teftonak and Rizu now. Wow, Razor making a mistake there. Well, Rizu now in the lead, followed by Warlord and Kalket. Oh, Kalket making a mistake there. Kawi and Sion will overtake him. Let's follow Sio here a little bit. give us a nice overview. Rizou in the lead, followed by Warlord, Kawi, and Siozo. If it's still like this, it might be a first blue round, actually. I think it will be. Yeah, there we go. It's gonna be 3-1. And, yeah, a lot of bugs in this map, it seems. I saw some players flying off. Into the fifth round we go. There we go, let's follow Adri here. Pretty strong Spanish player from Team Q. Not having the best of start, it seems. Rizou and... yeah, Rizou with the better start here. Together with Teftonak and Sion. Oh, someone made a mistake there. I think it was... a little bit behind here. No big deal. Oh, wow. That was a huge, huge mistake. Huge mistake. In the meantime, we have Razor in the lead, followed by Rizou. Rizou overtaking Razor now. Wow, very nice part there by Rizou. Almost no airtime. Keeping his grip. Okay, we also made a mistake there. Again with a mistake. This will be a red round, though, I think. It's gonna be close. It's gonna be close. I'm bad at math, so let's just wait. A draw. It's a draw. Thanks to all finishing in the last second. Kinda lucky, I think. But, you know. 3-1 still. Into the sixth round. Or technically the... technically the sixth. You could also say the fifth. Let's follow Teftonak here for a little bit. Having a pretty good start. Sion 2. Together with Rizou. Rizou having great starts here most of the time. Also Razor and Warlord, Kalket. All pretty good in front in the pack. That was Kalket making a mistake there. Kawi also in the back. And Razor as well with a like double slowdown somehow. All seems to be in the lead here. I don't know. Wow. It's... a lot of mistakes being made. In the lead, followed by Rizou, Xeon, Adri. The good speed there. Maktikt. Maktikt with a little bump and with the buck. So this might be another blue round. Yep, it's gonna be another blue round. So it's gonna be 2-3 in score here. A lot of mistakes here by a lot of players, to be honest. A lot of bugs as well. So, you know. Can't do much, you know, against the bugs, but it's a sign that you're taking too much risks most of the time, not always, but, you know. Taking the Rammsteins increases the risk of bugs. Good start here by Razor. Xion again with a good start. As well. And Rizou also again in the front. Adri also there, so right now is looking good for Team Q, actually. Three or four players in the top six. CO still in the lead, though. Oh, Rizou making a mistake there. Oops. CO, yeah. That's a very tricky little jump there. And all touching as well here. So we have Razor in front, followed by Adri and Teftonak. Is it going to be a Q round? Probably. Yeah, it's going to be a Q round here. It's going to be 4 points for Q and 2 points for Lycaser. A lot of bugs again in this round. Pretty unfortunate. Let's follow Warlord here for one round. Not having the best of starts. But in the middle of the pack, so anything's still possible. A lot of bugs will be coming up shortly, probably. CO in the lead, followed by Razor. Warlord going really close there. That was so risky. But this is looking good for Team Q, though. It's a lot of Q players in front. Only, let's see. Yeah, wow, look, top three is Team Q right now. Oh, and Odd touches the wall again in the same same part as last round. Oh, wow, crashes again. Wow. CO taking first there. That's... wow. But it's gonna be a red round anyway, I think. Yep, it's gonna be 5-2 here. And hello, Sundreps, by the way. I see you. Alright. Into round 8 we go. Let's follow... whoops. Let's follow Rizu here. Always having very good starts. And again. Wow, going really close there in that corner. Oh, but makes a mistake. Spectator's curse, I guess. And we have Razor in the lead, followed by Warlord, Kalkit, Steftonek. Yeah. Let's follow Razor here. Nope, Razor made a mistake. I don't know. Wow, he's back at the start somehow. That's a special. So we got three Team Q players in the lead. Oh, and Deftrank making the mistake. Three Team Q players in the lead. They should just save it. They have like a second in front of the fourth driver here, CO. So it's gonna be another... it's gonna be another red round here for Team Q. It's gonna be a 6-2, and it's gonna be map point right here. Hey, Arnie, what's up, man? Yeah, so serious. Where's the come on emote, Sundrips? I think I think Brecky made... or there are new emotes coming for him. So that's why he removed some, I think two. And we're back to the match. We have having a really good start here. Oh, falling back a little bit there. We have Razor and CO in the lead now. Let's see where Rizzo is here. Is also always having great starts. Also in front here. But we have three Team Q players in front, together with CO from Sir. So let's see if they can keep it. Yeah, we have three Team Q players in the top three right now, so it's gonna be another red round here. It's gonna be the map for Team Q. 7 points against 2 points for Leica Sir. GG, that's the first map. And now I don't know if it will be the 3v3, 2v2, or the 1v1. I guess it's gonna be the 3v3. And I don't know what map it will be on, to be honest. Let's see here. Oops, let's link the stream here. What? Why? Wait a minute. Oh, here we go. That's what I need. There we go. So this is gonna be Magdic, Kawi, and CO for Leica Sir, and Provan, which is Ivan, I think, and Kalkit for Team Q. Yeah, it's Ivan. I don't even know my own team, I'm sorry. They're just warming up here. Two more warm-up rounds and we will be alive. Oh, Harney, thanks for the follow, by the way. Much appreciated. Let's just follow the players like this. It's a pretty nice map this, to be honest. I like it. Long left corner here. Tricky platform part here with the dirt part. Easy to over or undercut it. Followed by a really fast part here. Sharp right corner and into the finish. One more warm up and we will be live with the 3 versus 3 on ESL Overperform. Alright, Arnie, yeah, he's my the 100th follower. Nice. Didn't even realize. Let's go in first person here. And follow Cowie a little bit in his last warm-up round. Hype. And the map will be a restart and we will be live. I need the co-caster, Arnie. I don't know, man. I don't know. I think it would be harder with the co-caster. Like, if you don't know each other very well. Like, you would start talking over each other and stuff. I don't know. Maybe one day. Maybe one day, me and Potsor. Or someone else. I don't know. But for now, I'll be doing it. We'll be doing it on my own, I think. And we will be going live here. Oh, here we go. Kawi, CEO, Magdikt versus Kalket, Ivan, and Ah. Here we go. No mistakes in the start by anyone, it seems. Kalket falling a little bit behind. Oh, there, that was a mistake. I don't know who it was. Kawi. And Ah also with their weird little slowdown there. We have Magdikt and Ivan in lead, followed by Zio. Zio in the lead right now. Kalket also pretty close. So it's basically 2v2 now. Oh, Kalket touching there. That's not good. That's not good. Seems like this will be a round for Team Lancaster. Oh, Magdikt crashed pretty hard there. So we have... Wow, it's actually going to be a Q round here. First place going for... it's going to be for CO, but... There are 3 places for Team Q, with Kalk, Provan and Ah. So now it's going to be 1-0 for Team Q. That's unexpected after the first 3 quarters of the map. Here we go into round 2. Let's follow Ah. And I think, I'm not sure actually, does he play first person? I don't know. But let's follow him this way for now. Having a pretty decent start here. Oof, that wasn't the best corner, I think. Might get a lot of speed here, but not really. We have CO and Kawi in the lead right now. Sonrups, yeah, this is the ESL CPS, like, well, league, kind of, and this is Division 3 out of 6 divisions. So it's not the best teams, not the worst teams, just decent players overall. And this is the fifth match in Division 3, I believe. Team Q has one map, drawed two maps or matches, and lost one. And I think Lycosur lost. No, I think they did draw one match, and I think they lost their other matches, if I'm not mistaken. I think I'm right there. So that was a blue round, by the way, that last round. Let's follow Kalket here for this round for now. Who are going very inside there. That's I'm still in the lead though. Looking good for Team Q so far, with three players in front here. Only Kawi. Oh, and Kawi crashes, and I think was it? I think Kalket as well. No, Ivan here. Ivan as well. So we have A and Kalket in the lead, followed by Maktik and CO. No, I don't join a random game in the league. this is kind of my team, Sonrups, Team Q. Wow, and A with a real pretty big lead here. 0.4 seconds ahead of CO. But he's followed by three Sir players, so it's going to be a blue round, I think. Yep, it's going to be another blue round. Kalk probably... I missed it, but I guess he had a bug. Mate, dude, Sonrups, lad. I'm on Team Q, man. But I'm not good enough to play, so that's why I stream. Let's follow CO here for a round. Having a pretty bad start. Kalket as well from Team Q there. Maktik with the best start, it seems. Ooh, CO. That was really close, actually. Maktik still in front, followed by A. Let's see if the platform part coming up will change anything. It's a little bit tricky. A lot of crashes there, it seems. This part right here. No, well, yep, CO crashed. Well, touched the wall, I guess. Didn't lose that much speed, but still fell behind. Still Maktik in front, followed by Kawi and A. Kalket with a lot of speed here. Gonna catch up. Top 2 is gonna be probably for like a team like a Sir here. Yep, it's gonna be another blue round, I think. Yep. So that's gonna be a 3-1. Hello, Curious, welcome. Alright, let's follow Kawi here. Seems to have pretty decent rounds here. Wow, having a bad start together with Xio. Already 0.3 seconds behind almost, the both of them. Kalket also having a little bit of a slowdown there. Maktik again in front, having great starts on this map. Followed by A and Ivan. Ooh, Kawi touching again. See you also in the back, so this should be a round for Team Q. Ooh, Provan making a little mistake there, that's unfortunate. Ah, in the front though, before Maktik and Kalket. Ah, having a decent lead now. 3500 of a second. And this is going to be a Q round for sure. So that's going to be 3-2-1. Or 3-2-2, sorry. So we might be seeing a little bit of a comeback here. Let's successful on Magdek here. He's having great starts, and again, he's in the front here. Together with Ah and Sio. Ooh, that was... Wow, yeah, that's GG. He fell off the map. And I don't think respawn is allowed in ESL, so that's unfortunate for him. There should be a Q round. I don't know if they're communicating on TeamSpeak. I don't think so. But they still have to get... I don't know. I'm not sure if Team Sir gets top 2. If... Wow, Kaui is far, far behind though. Oh, and Kalket also retired, so I don't know what happened there, but... oh, and the... Oh, just... Wow. Q's gonna lose this round. That's pretty amazing. That is pretty amazing. Wow. Wow, that's pretty unbelievable that Q managed to lose that round. That is... wow. So... Magdek fell off the map in the start. Kalket retired for some reason. I don't know why. I didn't see what happened there. And then in the finish, or right before the finish, Ah managed to fall off the map as well. That was pretty amazing. Here we go. All six players still in it, I think. I don't see Magdek, he's behind here. Oh, Kalket made a mistake as well. Gotta be overtaken by Magdek, I think. Maybe not. They're very close. So we have Provan or Ivan in the lead, followed by Kaui. Ah, overtaking Zio right now. Oh, making a mistake, touching the wall. That's unfortunate, man. Oh, Provan making a mistake as well. So... Wow, Kaui and Zio just have to finish, and this will be another. Oh! Kaui just frontally. Wow, just straight into the fucking wall there. That's pretty amazing. So, this is still a red round. That is pretty amazing. That's amazing. So, 4-3 right now in points. So, this is pretty, pretty tight actually. This is pretty close. But we see a lot of big mistakes. Some bugs as well, but also just a lot of mistakes. We have Ah in the front now, followed by Magdek. Kalket now overtaking Magdek. Sion as well in the front, Kaui. Oh, and Kaui making the mistake. Oh, and Magdek touching there. And Ivan or Provan also. Falling behind with Ah and Kalket in the lead now, followed by Sio. Let's see if they can keep it that way. Sio overtaking Kalket there. It's kind of back and forth in the front there. Provan touching again. Let's follow Magdek here. Have a little overview there of the first three players. Oh, Sio and Ah both making a little mistake there. Slowing down, so Kalket will take this round, followed by Magdek, Ah, Sio, Provan. So it's gonna be a red round, I think. Pretty sure. So it's gonna be a four draw. So wow, this is pretty close. Pretty close. A lot of mistakes from both teams here. Magdek with a bad start for once, falling behind immediately after the start. But this time, I think it's Kaui who's in front. Well, Magdek's still in the back here. So we have Sio in the lead, followed by Ah and Kalket. And Ivan, or Provan. So, if they keep this up, this will be... Another point for Team Q. So we have Kaui and Zio in the back. And the three Team Q players in front for once. Oh, and Ah having it. Wow. Having a bug there. That's unfortunate. Where is he? Oh, here he is. Still a fourth, though. There's gonna be a Q point for sure. So there we go. We have a little comeback here from Team Q. I think they were 3-0 or 3-1 behind, and now they're 4-5 in front. So there you go. Into around 10 we go here. Let's follow Ivan here. Oh, and someone made a mistake. Was that Calcat? No. It was Mactic here. I don't know. Was that a bug or just a mistake? I'm not sure. Ah, also making a mistake there. Falling behind. So we have Calcat followed by CO and Provan and Cowie. So it stays like this. It will be another point for Team Q, but well, a lot can happen in this last couple of turns. Calcat still in the front. Ooh, CO having a lot of speed there, I think. Might overtake Calcat in this next corner. Having a very good line there. Ooh, it's gonna be very close for the first two there. Ooh, oh, and CO takes it. Wow, that was close. Good race. Good race. That was, wow. 0.04 seconds between the first two there. That was really close. So 4-6 now for Team Q. This is map point. They might take the second map here after they took the 5 versus 5. They might win the 3v3 as well. Lucio taking the risks there, really close to the edge. Calcat and Provan having a great start. Ah, where is Ah? Did he make a mistake? Yep, he had a bad start there. Oh, making another. So we have Magdic in front now. Ooh, Calcat with a lot of speed there. It was too close to call at this point. When I think Provan made a mistake or had a bug there. Because he fell behind. But Calcat in front, followed by the three Sir players. Ooh, Xio going really close to the edge there again. But Calcat with a good first place, but it won't be enough. This will be a blue round. So it's going to be a 5-6. Alright, into the 12th round we go. Oh, someone had a bad start. Well, that might have been just lag. Calcat in front, having a pretty good map here. Pretty nice lead. Oh, it touches the wall, that's unfortunate. Taking the risks. So we have Xiu in front now, followed by Ah. Let's see what the young Swede can do here. Taking a very wide line here. Oh, and touching. That's unfortunate. So we have Xiu in front before Ivan. Oh, and Provan or Ivan overtakes Xiu there. So it's going to be a Q round because Ah and Calcat are in third and fourth place. Wow. So that's going to be GG. That's 5-7 for Team Q. That's the second map they take home. So now it's only the 1v1 and the 2v2 left. Ah, you guys in chat. Alright, here we go. Into ESL Arabidopsis. I don't know who comes up with those names, but yeah. So this is gonna be the 2v2, I think. But Team Q kinda already won the map, I think, or the match, I think. Because the 3v3 and the 5v5 are worth more points than the 1v1 and the 2v2. But I guess they will play the 2v2 and the 1v1 here. So let's see who will play this. I guess it's gonna be the 2v2. Well, it's unclear at the moment. They're talking about it, I guess. Sondreps, why so many Swedish players? Because Team Q is actually, well, it is an international-like team, but it's predominantly Swedish. So that's why there are so many Swedish players. But we have all kinds of nationalities, to be honest. We have a couple of Spanish players. There we go. Yeah, we have a couple of Spanish players, we have, I think, a Slovakian player, we have people from all around, actually. But most of them are Swedish, that is correct. So I don't know, this is going to be the 2v2, 1v1? I guess it's going to be the 1v1 first. Razer attempting to fly to the moon right there, but he failed, unfortunately. How many players are in the team, Sondreps? Well, officially, like in the ESL team for Team Q, I think there are like 12 players. Let me check that for you. 13 players in the ESL squad. The entire team, I guess something around 16 players, something like that. Alright, so it's gonna be the 1v1. Between a Calcutta Spanish player and CEO, who is he a Belgian player? It's a Belgian team, like a sir. Yep, Belgian player. So let's follow CEO for the first round here. CEO with the slight lead, 1/10 of a second in front of Calcutt. Calcutt taking the lead here, it's really close. Yep, Calcutt in the lead there, ooh, taking the risk over the Rammstein inside there, that is ballsy. CEO really close behind him though, taking the lead maybe? Nope, Calcutt with more speed. Ooh, CEO with the inside line here, but Calcutt again with more speed, so this should be a round for Calcutt, or Calc. There we go, that's a point for Team Q. pretty close round, actually. 0.08 seconds. Into the second round we go. Both of them having a good start. Kalket with a slight lead, maybe? No, it's Xion coming out with more speed right there. Oh, but Kalket. Nope, it's gonna be Xion in front here. Let's see if Kalket can close the gap. But right now, I think it's it's 0.2 seconds. Ooh, CO had to break there, I think. Well, still a quarter of a second in front. It's gonna be more now, I think. Yeah, 0.4. So he can pretty much save it right now. He can pretty much save it and secure the round. Oof, that was really close to the inside edge there. But this is gonna be a 0.4 CO, so it's gonna be all tied up here. Razor, where's the face cam? Yeah, I'm not gonna do a face cam like during during a cast. Like, I'd like to like show the entire screen of the Trackmania thing. So my face is distracting the viewers, I think. Hello, Narok82, welcome, man. All right, CO again with the lead in the start. Kalket took the inside there, but yeah, lost some speed there, so CO again. And you see the difference there, CO taking the inside, Kalket the outside of the pole. Kalket taking the risks there, but he should have taken the risks earlier on, I think, because right now I think it's too late, he's half a second behind. Ooh, and almost touched the wall there. Yeah, it's 0.7 seconds. Again, inside-outside difference. CO going for really tight lines there. And it's gonna be another point for Team Like a Sir. For people just tuning in, Team Q won the 5 versus 5 and the 3 versus 3. They started out with those matchups, and now it's a 1v1. Next up will be the 2 versus 2 on this map as well. And Xio again taking the lead in the start. Kalket catching up a little bit though. But I'm afraid the inside full lines here. Oh wow, Xio taking the outside now as well. But still gets more speed. Oh, and touches the wall, I think. Ooh, Kalket really close there to those edges. Really close. But he is 0.6 in front. I hope he's on TeamSpeak or something and someone warns him to save it, because if he would crash now, that would be unfortunate. But he will take the point for sure. Yeah, Xio crashing again there. So it's gonna be all tied up, 2 points each. Into the fifth round we go. Really close right now. Kalket with a slight lead after start. Ooh, CO with a mistake there. That's unfortunate. So Kalket can actually save it if he wants. I think. Yes, 0.7 in front, 0.6 now. Had a pretty bad part there, but again, 0.7 seconds in front, so 0.8 now. That's gonna be a point in the bag if he doesn't crash. He just has to finish, basically. And he can... Ooh, and he crashes! He crashes, so CO gonna overtake him and gonna steal the point away there. Oof. That is unfortunate. Oh, that is unfortunate. I guess that is why some teams use TeamSpeak. Because when you get warrants that you are, like when you get notify you that you're 0.8 of a second in front, you know, that changes everything. You can just avoid any risks and just take every corner like a bit wider, a bit safer, and just finish the round and just take the point. Because, you know, like right now, he just kept risking it, and that's what cost him the point right there. Ooh, and Kalkit crashes on the pole there. So it's going to be another point for CO here. So that's going to be 4-2. That was unfortunate. Again, taking a little bit too much risk, maybe. And a pretty decent time as well from CO there. Into the seventh round with a 4-2 lead for Team Leikeser. Let's see if Kalkit can bring it back here. Having a decent start. A point, a 1300th of a second, 16 now in front of CO. But CO having a pretty good second part of the map, or last part of the map. There we go, he's in the lead already. Kalkit going very inside line there, but well, it pays off, I guess. He is in the lead, but CO with a little bit more speed there, and they are really close together there. And again, the difference in style there, outside versus inside line. Oh, this is going to be a really close round, I think. Oh, this is going to be Kalkit in front, I think. Yep. Good race. That was a really close round. So he brings it back to 4-3. Let's see if he can make it 4-all here. That would be nice. Oh. CO with the better start, though. Well, Kalkit not far behind. Oh, and having a bug there. Saves it, kind of, but he is a 0.2 seconds behind. And having a really wide line there. Well, 0.3 seconds. Still keeping a little bit of pressure on CO here. Let's see if CO can avoid any mistakes, because then Kalkit is in the front. 0.4 seconds now, 0.44. It's going to be more now because the inside outside difference, I think. So it's going to be another point for CO. So it's going to be 5 points for Leikeser, and still 3 points for Team Q. Again, I think the point limit here is 7 in the 1v1. So, not over yet. Kalkit with a pretty tight start here. Ooh, Xio with a pretty nice line, but they are really close to each other. Ooh, Kalkit taking a nice lead here. Ooh, but going too much outside there. Ooh, CO having a little bump, but it didn't affect his speed, and Kalkit made a mistake there, or had a bug, I don't know. But that's not good here. That's gonna be another point for CO, I guess. Yeah, he's almost 2 seconds in front, so something weird will have to happen. For Kalkit to win this, so it's gonna be a 6-3. It's gonna be a map point here, or sub match point, I guess. So he's gonna have like, 4 match points. So So let's see if Xio can close it out immediately. Or if Kalkat can bring it back a little bit. You never know. Anything can happen. A couple of mistakes, couple of bugs, and he's right back into this match. Xio taking the lead though. Kalkat not far behind. Really close right now. He's in the lead now even. That is slowed down a little bit there, and I think Xio had a lot more speed there. So Kalkat will have to and he touches. That is GG. He retires. So that is GG. Likeser to win a sub match here, the 1v1. After losing the 3v3 and the 5v5. And let's go to the 2v2, the last sub-match of this match. So I guess Team Q already won the match, but... Xio drove a really nice 1v1 there, I have to say. Xio from Likeser won the 1v1 Harney against Kalkat. 7-2-3, I guess it was. So the 2v2, I guess, will be Razor and Awe versus Kawi and Maktik. Maybe Xio will play this one as well, but I think it's gonna be Kawi and Maktikt versus Razor and Awe. Well, Harney, we won the 3v3 and the 5v5, so we kinda won the match, I guess. But yeah, Xio drove a really strong 1v1. Especially is the second part of the map, he was really strong, taking the inside poles every time, while Kalkat took the outsides, thus gaining a little bit every time. And it was a really strong sub match from Xio. So we're warming up, waiting for the restart before we go live. Six O would have been better. How do you mean, Arnie? Oh yeah. You mean in the in the total points? Well, you know, a win is a win, man. Yeah. And we can still take it 5-1, I guess, if we win the 2v2. So, you know, 5-1 or 2-1? No, 4-2. Wow. Math, GG. A win is a win in my book, so... I mean, we have Razor and Awe here, two really strong players. Also playing for Team Sweden. Let's see what they can do versus Maktikt and Kawi. Good luck, have fun. Live we go into the last sub match, the 2v2 on ESL Arabidopsis. I probably butchered that name, but you know, who calls a map like that, man? Jesus. Alright, off we go. let's spectate are here. The young Swedish Trackmania prodigy. And let's go in a first person mode. Here we go. I'll taking the lead as well, I think, together with nope, Magdic is in front. Here we go, now we can see the opponents. Magdic in front, followed by Razor and Kawi with a lot of speed there. All taking the outside pole. Xio took the inside there, which is kind of risky, I guess, but a little bit faster. Magdic still in front. Oh, Magdic cutting, crashing on the edge there. So we have Razor and R in the lead now, followed closely by Kawi. Can I? Oh, here he is. Oh, Kawi taking inside there. But this should be a Q round. Yeah. Wow. Yeah. R even overtakes Kawi in the end. Really nice finish by R there. Yeah, Kawi having a little slowdown there. Let's follow him for the beginning of this round. Having a good start in the lead. Pretty far in the lead even. .07, which is, well, I guess not that much, but wow, all overtaking him there, taking a really tight line. Oh, and all clipping the wall there, that's unfortunate. Oh, Magdic also trying the inside line there, I think. Or just crashed into the pole. So R overtaking him here, so if Razor can overtake Kawi here and finish first, this might be... if the positions stay like this, it will be a draw, I think. If Razor takes first, yeah, it will be a draw. So it's gonna stay 0-1-0 for Team Q. Off we go. Let's follow Magdic here. Ooh, wow, having a weird bounce there. Lost some speed. The Kawi also lost some speed there. Sir, not having the best of starts here. Oh, and Razor really close to each other in front. Quarter of a second to be exact. Oh, and Magdic, what? I thought he touched. Oh, and Kawi touched, and Razor as well. But he keeps a good speed, Razor. Well, kind of. Magdic's gonna overtake him, I think, but is pretty far in front here, almost half a second. Ooh, wow, looked like oh, and Magdic touches and Razor as well. But it's gonna be a Q round for sure. I don't know where Kawi is. Oh, there he is. So it's gonna be 2-0 for Team Q in the 2v2. Point limit in the 2v2 is 5 points. In the other sub matches, wow, 3 bugs there in the start. Magdic, Kawi, and Aw having the least of the 3 bugs, but Magdic and Kawi really far behind here. So it's gonna be a 3 point for Team Q here. Looks like they're still kind of risking, which is kind of unnecessary since they have 5.5 seconds in front of Kawi and wow, having a weird little bug there, and 8.5 seconds in front of Magdic. That's a weird name to pronounce. And there we go, 3 point for Team Q. And as you can see, maybe in the top here, the times that Xio set in the 1v1 are still up here. He still has the top 3 fastest times. So yeah, that shows how good he drove there in the 1v1. Off we go into the fourth round. Let's follow Arthur a bit here. Decent start again by the two Swedish players for Team Q. Maktik then, and Razor, what happened? Wow, that was a, I guess a Rammstein bug. But R still in front. If he keeps, if he keeps this, it will be a draw. Oh, and Kawi crashing there, but Razor is really far behind, so it's probably gonna be a draw unless R crashes somehow. But he is a half second in front, but wow, it always looks like he makes a mistake there, but wow, he did! He touched! Oh, wow, this is gonna be a point for Lycaser. Okay, well, maybe not, because Kawi, Kawi's not gonna finish. Kawi is not gonna finish, he is on his back, and respawning is not allowed in ESL, so it's gonna be another point for Team Q. It's gonna be 4-0, so this is a match point already. Off you go in potentially the last. Oh, and wow, Maktik already making a mistake there in the start. Ah, as well crashing, Razor as well crashing. Kawi is the only one who didn't make a mistake there. We have Kawi in front, followed by Razor. And ah, and I think Maktik, he retired, so it's gonna be GG here. It's gonna be 5-0, unless a Q player retires, or Razor, but I don't think that's gonna happen. So this will be 5-0. So that will. Wow, Razor still crashes there. Let's hope. Yeah. They will be able. Yeah, they will be able to finish. So it's got, wow, and they're BMing. Oh, he's BMing here. Oh boy. Kawi didn't even finish. He disconnected already. So well, that's GG. So Lycaser won the 1v1, but other than that, Team Q won everything. The 2v2, the 3v3, and the 5v5. So that's gonna be it. That was the fifth match of the group stage of ESL CPS 15 in group 3, this is. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I see you next time.